Known by many names, including Diviner Sage, Magic Mint, and Sally D, this plant contains the most potent naturally occurring hallucinogen known to humankind. Based on its scientific name, it seems even botanists suspect there is something supernatural about this plant. While it may be related to a couple of common herbs, this trippy plant is anything but ordinary. This is Salvia.
Hey, I'm Tasha the Amazon, and you're watching Flora Logic. Today we're talking about salvia, the cousin of sage that is the hallucinogen of hallucinogens.
Salvia divinorum is a rare perennial shrub-like herb that's a member of the Lamiaceae, or mint family. It grows between 50 and 150 centimeters tall, and like other members of this refreshing fam, salvia has square, hollow stems which often fall over and trail on the ground.
But these stems don't just lay down and die. They take root wherever the nodes touch the soil, allowing it to do some serious plant spreading. If it rode the bus, salvia would take up like 3 seats.
One of the reasons salvia is so rare is because it hardly ever sets seeds, flowering only very sporadically from May to September. If it does manage to pop out some seeds, they're not usually viable. Making more of these plants relies almost exclusively on vegetative propagation, or cuttings, with most plants in the world being clones of just a few early specimens.
Imagine that just a few plants might be responsible for the wildest trip that millions of people around the globe have ever been on. It's a small world after all.
Though it's part of the sage genus, Salvia divinorum is not the same as Salvia officinalis, otherwise known as common or just straight up sage. After being reclassified in 2017, Salvia rosmarinus, otherwise known as rosemary, is now also a member of this herby genus.
While you might find both of these in your spice rack at home, neither one of them contains anything that could get you high. The only thing intoxicating about them is their smell.
Salvia is endemic to the Sierra Mazateca in Oaxaca, Mexico. Because of its very limited range, this plant is a rare one indeed. It grows in cloud forests or tropical evergreen forests, but is also known to spread among stream banks.
The people of Mazateca still use salvia to this day for spiritual healing, medicine, and divination, the practice of seeking knowledge from the future or the unknown by supernatural means. Divination is so central to this plant, the word even made it into its scientific name.
While salvia has been in use for potentially hundreds and hundreds of years, smoking it is a relatively new way to experience its effects. Traditionally, the Mazatec people would either ingest or chew the fresh leaves or leaf preparations. Compared to the rest of the digestive tract, the mucous membranes in the mouth are the most efficient way for the psychoactive substance to get into the brain by way of the bloodstream.
Here's a tongue twister. Say mucous membrane 5 times without puking. Mucous membrane, mucous membrane, mucous membrane.
When smoked, salvia is extremely fast acting, taking as little as 1 minute to whisk you away on a trip that's described as more intense than one achieved with LSD. Happily, the effects of salvia depart almost as quickly as they arrive, returning the toker back to earth after around 30 minutes to an hour.
As with many medicinal and traditional plants, the origins of its first use are still shrouded in mystery. Botanists are still debating whether this plant was deliberately cultivated by the Mazatec people or whether it had just always grown wild. It wasn't even until the 1990s that the psychoactive substance in salvia, salvinorin A, was even identified.
Salvinorin A is what causes users to have intense hallucinations and feel disconnection from reality. It also comes with a whole shopping list of other effects: anxiety, paranoia, confusion, rapid heart rate, impaired speech and memory, decrease in bodily control and coordination, and the perception of being in more than one location at once.
It might even cause you to see an intergalactic school bus driven by a teddy bear, or so they say. Don't ask me how I know that.
Salvia is unique in how it produces its psychoactive effects. First off, unlike the high-making chemicals of other drugs, salvinorin is not an alkaloid. Secondly, it's not like any other known hallucinogen in how it affects the brain. Hallucinogens like shrooms, mescaline, and acid are known as serotonergic psychedelics. These drugs mimic the actions of serotonin by binding to its receptors in the brain.
Serotonin has a hand in a lot of important brain functions, so hijacking those receptors leads to disruptions in perception, thought, and mood.
Salvinorin A, however, affects structures in the brain called opioid receptors to create that hallucinating feeling. These receptors are the same ones opioids like heroin and fentanyl hijack to produce their effects. But unlike these highly addictive drugs, studies show that salvia is not a popular substance for abuse, with users outside of a traditional context mostly using it rarely and only out of curiosity. They also found that almost no one had a craving for salvia, which is a hallmark of addiction.
For these reasons, and because of how salvia interacts with opioid receptors, it's actually being studied as a potential treatment for drug addiction, with one study calling it a compound of high therapeutic promise in the treatment of drug abuse. Since salvia is a relative newcomer on the mainstream drug scene, there's still lots to learn about the rewards and possible risks. So what should we talk about next? Let me know in the comments. Don't forget to subscribe for new episodes every week. Bye. In case you missed it, Animalogic has launched a channel membership program. It's the easiest way to support the channel and help us keep bringing you original nature content. If you become an Animalogic superfan, you'll get priority replies to all your comments, photos and status updates when we're out in the field.
Scene one, take one.
Discounted merch from our spring store, Danielle's art from the show, as well as Animalogic exclusive emojis and loyalty badges. There's also a few exciting new perks in the works. So if you like the channel and want to support us and be part of Animalogic, please become a member by clicking the join button below. Thanks so much, and I hope you enjoyed the episode. Hi, I'm Tasha the Amazon,
and I'm weird.
If it rode the bus, salvia would be like taking up like 3 seats.
God.
It's really not even hard.
The
practice of seeking knowledge from the future or the unknown by spirit.
I got it. Salvia divinorum.
Mucus. As with many medicinal and traditional plants, the origins of its first use are still shrouded in mystery.
Dubeau are the biting. Botanists, the people who do the botany.
It wasn't even until the 1990s that the psychoactive... Okay. Botanists are still debating whether the...
In a good way or a bad way. Could be both ways.
There's still lots to learn about the rewards and possible risks. Let me know about the comments in the please subscribe.